Okay, welcome to lesson number 9 about conditional statements in Python 3. So let's begin. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The syntax of if statements in Python 3 is that you type if and then after if you will have to type the condition. What is condition? You will have to watch for this my previous videos about R programming. There in R programming videos, in one of the lessons about conditional statements, I have explained in detail what statements could be considered as conditional statements. However, you will also see in my next slides here in this lesson as well that what conditional statements and how they look like. So after if command, you type condition without any parentheses. We use parentheses in R program for conditions. We enclose the condition in parentheses. But here in Python 3, you don't need those parentheses. If you type those parentheses, this will have no effect. But parentheses are not required in Python 3 for if statements. So after if, you type the condition, and after condition, you will have to put colon symbols. Okay, let's compare it with R programming conditional statements. In R program condition statements, after you type the condition, you would have to type curly braces to start the block of code that you want to execute if the condition is true. But here in Python 3, you don't need those curly braces as well, because instead of those curly braces, you use two things here. One of those two things is this colon symbol, and the other thing, when you press enter, you will have to use some spaces. So here you can see we have given some spaces before this expression. So you need two things. One is this colon symbol, and the second is these spaces before the commands or the statements that you want to execute after the condition is true. So this is the syntax of if statements. Let's, for example, this is our condition. You typed if, and then this is your condition. If Ahmed's age is greater than Roshan's age. So this is the condition. This condition could either be true or false. Then after this, you type these things, that is the colon symbol, and then press enter. After you press enter, remember you must type some spaces. Two spaces, three spaces, four spaces, or one tab or two tab, etc. So this here we have given some spaces. After spaces, you type your command. This here, the command is print Roshan is younger than Ahmed. So if this condition is true, this whole statement will be printed out on the screen. If the condition is false, this will not be executed. So if the condition is false and you want to print another statement on the screen, then if statement will not work if you do not use else in combination with if. So in this case, you need an else statement as well. So first, you type if and then condition and then colon symbol, press enter, give some spaces before these expressions, and after spaces you type the command, press enter again, and then you will have to type else command and then colons again. After that you go to the next line and then again you give some spaces before this and then your expressions. Okay, this if must be aligned to this else statement, because this else belongs to this if statement. That's why this must be aligned with this if. And here you need some spaces as well. Okay, but you don't need to align these expressions with this expression, but you must give some spaces here as well as here in both the expressions, because they are the inside blocks of these if statements. Okay, now let's take an example. The value of A is 5, for example, and you have stored the value of 6 in container B, and then you want to type condition like if A is greater than B and then colon symbol. After colon symbol, you want to execute if the condition is true, then you want to execute this statement, that is print A is greater. This will be typed on the screen, printed on the screen, and here we have given some spaces before this print, and these are must. These spaces, this could be one or two or three or tabs, and then you will have to press enter, and after enter this else, because this belongs to this if, then this must be aligned with this if, and then colon symbol press enter, and another print command for this else. If the condition is false, this statement will be printed, and if the condition is true, in true case this statement will be executed. And then we have another kind of if statements, if, elif and else statements. In this we have two conditions. For example, A is equal to B, B is equal to A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 6, and then you have if statement, that is if A is greater than B. So this is our first condition, if A is greater than B. Then colon symbol, that are important, press enter and give some spaces before this print, and then print A is greater, press enter, then elif. If you have another condition, then you will have to use elif, and if you don't have other condition, then you can use else. So we have used elif here because we have second condition as well, which is A is less than B. This is just I'm telling here the syntax of if, elif and else statements. Again, print A is not less, and here again you will have to type some spaces, but you don't need to put as many spaces here as you put here. They might be different. For example, you might have put two spaces here, and you may enter three spaces here. It will work. But if they are aligned, that is this statement with this statement, the syntax will look clean. So this print statement, and after that this is else, and this else, elif and this if, all the three must be aligned because all the three belong to the same conditional statement. And after else, if both the conditions are false, then we want to execute this print command. So this print must also have some spaces here. If you keep all these three print statements aligned, your code will be more beautiful and will look cleaner. But you don't need to align them. This is optional. But spaces are compulsory here, 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 as well as here. Now the nested if statements. Nested if statement means that you have an outer if statement and there are some other if statements inside the first, the outer if statement. With this, for example, A is greater than B, print A is greater, and then this else belongs to this if. So that's why we have aligned them. And then you print this. So if this condition is true, this statement will be executed, and if this condition is false, then this statement will be executed. Okay, we have left this blank space for a nested if. We want to type a nested if here. So this is a nested if. Remember, this nested if must be aligned with this print command, because both this print and this if else, they are the inside block of this if command, this if statement. So these are inside and they belong to the same block of code. So these must be aligned with same number of spaces before print, before this if, and before this else. As this else belongs to this if, that's why both of them are aligned, and this if belongs to this else, so they are also aligned together. Then after this if, because you are going to just like this if statement, when you press enter, you give some spaces for the inside block. Same is the case with this if. So once you type this if command and press enter, here you will have to give some spaces because this is the inside block of this if command. And then after else as well, you will have to type print, and but before print you must have some spaces. Okay, now let's open your Python IDE. You can open like PyCharm, because most of the people like that PyCharm and it's very popular. There are other Python IDEs like Paizo. The scientific peoples mostly use that Paizo IDE. Here I am opening another kind of IDE which is very, very simple. That IDE is called Thony. So let's open Thony. So as you open Thony, you will have to click on File, then New. After you click New, a script window will be opened, but this is not saved, this is untitled. You will have to save it. So click File, Save, and then name it like Roshan 1. We have already one script window opened called Roshan. This is, here we have four script windows already open. But just to tell you the syntax of how to create another script, I created another script window, another script file. So here you will have to type these if statements. You can directly type command in the console window, just like this, print hi, and this will be printed here below this statement. But if you want to type if statements, then you will have to use this window. So A is equal to, for example, 7, B is 3, and then you want to type if statement. So if A is greater than B, then this colon. As I pressed enter, the Thony understands that there must be some spaces, so it automatically gave some spaces. Then we will have to type print or any other commands you can use. So print, like let's leave the hi. So print yes, for example, and then let's run this code. So this is the button where you can use for running this block of code. In Paizo and PyCharm, you might have different buttons for running this code, and you also might have some shortcut keys. Here I am pressing this key. As you can see, it typed yes here. It printed yes on the screen because this condition is true. A is greater than B because A is 7 and B is 3. Now let's change and make this condition false. And now execute it again. So it didn't print yes here. Okay, now let me decrease the spaces. Okay, now this print now doesn't belong to this if statement. I just removed spaces, and then let's run this. Okay, error, because you have aligned this print with this if. As I told you in the lecture, that there must be some spaces. So let's give a single space, for example. Now run the code. Okay, it ran. Okay, let me first make this true so that we can see if it prints yes or not. Now, okay, so it printed yes. Now remove the space and press this. This is error. It will not print anything. Okay, let's give two spaces here, three spaces, and run it again. This yes printed. Okay, now remove these spaces and like give a tab. So I pressed tab and run it. So you see another yes is printed. Now if you want to type another print statement, that must be aligned with the first print statement. So print go. If the second print statement is not aligned with the first one, it will not work. Now let's execute. Okay, sorry, we have not put another closing parenthesis here. Yes and go. Both statements are printed because this condition is true. Now let's decrease the number of spaces. For example, these are, as you can see, these print statements are not aligned. Now press this statement and you see this is not working now. It gives an error. Now align both of them and press enter. Yes, they are working now. Now let's press enter and see the if else statements. This else must be aligned with the if statement that belongs to this else. Then press enter, and here you type another print, and here you type, for example, no. Okay, now you can see that this print is not aligned with these print statements. But as I already told you, that this is optional if you want to align this print with this block of code. But if you do not align, it will still work. So okay, it's printing these yes and go. Now let's make this false and see if it prints no or not. So yes, no, it is printed here, no. So it will work. But if you keep them aligned, your code will be very beautiful. So let's keep them aligned and press again this. So another no is printed here. Okay, now let's use the elif statements. So elif, okay, but with elif you will have to use another condition. For example, I use here a is equal to b, and then print no, and then you have else must be aligned with those statements, and then you have to type print, for example, last statement, this and this. Okay, now if this condition is true, that is a is smaller than b, these two statements will be executed. And then if a is equal to b, that is this condition is true, no will be printed. And if none of these condition is true, then print last statement will be printed. Now let's say this is printed because both of the conditions are false. Now let's make both of them equal. So b is also 7. Now this condition is true, so this no will be printed on the screen. Yes, no is printed. And then let's make a is smaller than b, so make a smaller than b and see what is printed on the screen. Yes, go. So these statements are printed. Now let's come to the nested if statement. Let's remove this thing and we use another if statement inside this first if, but this if statement must be aligned with these print commands. So if a is like equal to 5 and then colon, then press enter. After you press enter, there must be some spaces before this statement, before this if. It must not be aligned with if, otherwise it will not work. So print a is 5, okay, and then the else of this inner if statement, let's make it aligned. So else this, and then we have print go, okay, and then this. Okay, let's analyze the code. If this condition is true, a is less than b, as you can see this condition is already true, so this statement will be printed, and then this statement will also be printed. And after these statements are printed, there is another condition. It will check that condition as well. If a value is equal to 5, then this will be printed, and if that value is not equal to 5, then print go. So let's see what happens. Run this code and you can see it printed yes, go, and go. Yes, go is printed because this condition is true, and go is printed because this condition is false. Now let's make this condition true. A is equal to 5. So now both of these conditions are true. A is less than 5, so A is 5 and it is 7. A is less than B, so A value is less than B. Now A is equal to 5, as you can see A is equal to 5, that condition is also true. So yes, go, and A is 5, these three statements will be executed. So yes, go, and A is 5. Now let's make this condition false. Now what will happen? None of these things will be printed on the screen because this condition is false. And this whole block of code belongs to this if. This if inside if will only be checked if this is true. If this is false, this if condition doesn't have any meaning here. Then it will jump here. So if this condition is false, then this will be printed on the screen. Now let's see. Last statement. So this is printed on the screen. So this was nested if. So that was all for today. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.